Dear students, the topic is DNA replication. Replication is the process of duplication of DNA. Duplication of DNA. Duplication of DNA or synthesis of new strands of DNA from parent strands. Watson-Crick model of DNA follows semi-conservative mechanism of DNA replication. What is semi-conservative mechanism? In DNA replication, one strand is parent strand and the other is the new strand. That means parent strand will act as template for the synthesis of a new strand. See how DNA replication take place. See here, if this is a double-stranded DNA, double-stranded DNA will undergo replication. There are many steps in DNA replication. Moreover, DNA replication is an energy-consuming process. That means more energy is required for the DNA replication. For this, the substances are ribonucleotide diphosphatases give energy like ATP molecules. See here, the double-stranded DNA, what will happen to this? First, the double-stranded DNA will unwind, which will unzip or unwind. The double-stranded DNA will unwind or unzip with the help of the enzyme called DNA helicase. DNA helicase. This enzyme unwind the double-stranded DNA into or unzipping enzyme. Helicase is otherwise called unzipping enzyme, which will unzip the double-stranded DNA. Then after that, which will again cut. So what will happen? When DNA helicase act on it, a Y-shaped structure will form. This is called a replication fork. And these are the parental strand. Parental strands or parallel strands, or we can say they are templates. Templates. Templates are formed. Then in the replication form, two strand newly synthesized, this red colored line is the newly synthesized strands. Here one strand will replicate continuously. So this is what is called a continuous strand. The other strand will replicate discontinuously. Means here and there the replication will take place. So this is called a discontinuous strand. See, in a replication fork, one strand is continuous. This is otherwise called leading strand. Continuous strand is otherwise called a leading strand, and the discontinuous strand is called a lagging strand. One is the leading strand and the other is called a lagging strand. So in the lagging strand, here and there the discontinuously DNA undergo the replication. Then the fragments of DNA that is seen in the lagging strand are called Okazaki fragments. They are called as Okazaki fragments. That fragments are called Okazaki fragments, the name given to honor the scientist Okazaki. Next we can see what are the enzymes involved in DNA replication.
Let us examine the replication machinery, the enzymes and machineries for DNA replication. The first one is primase, which help in the synthesis of RNA primer. The next one is DNA polymerase 3. It is a DNA dependent DNA polymerase help to synthesize new DNA fragments and provide DNTPS. Then another one is DNA polymerase 1 is otherwise called proofreading enzyme and DNA ligase. Ligase help to join the replicated fragments of DNA. The other enzyme is topoisomerase, relieve the torsional strain in DNA in front of the replication fork. Telomerase is RNA dependent DNA polymerase, an enzyme that can make DNA using RNA as a template.
So next we can see how this DNA replication takes place through an animation.
DNA replication is said to be semi-conservative as it contains one parent strand and a newly synthesized strand. DNA has a double-stranded structure made up of nitrogen bases like adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine with a double helical structure. This double helical structure has two antiparallel strands. One is from 5 prime to 3 prime end and the other is 3 prime to 5 prime end. Then during the replication of DNA, the DNA helicase will unwind the DNA strand. So two Y-shaped replication fork is formed. In the replication fork, primase act on it and synthesize RNA primer by adding RNA bases. When RNA primer is added to the unwinded strand, DNA polymerase 3 act on it and which start to synthesize the DNA strand by adding DNA bases in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction, which continuously synthesize the DNA fragment and form a leading strand. Opposite to the leading strand, we can see lagging strand. In the lagging strand also, primase act on it and form Okazaki fragments. Means here and there the replication takes place discontinuously. Primase act on it and RNA primer is formed. Then DNA polymerase bind to it and start to synthesize DNA bases and again which continues to synthesize the newly synthesized DNA strand in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. Finally, exonuclease removes the RNA primer and again DNA polymerase synthesize the DNA chain or DNA strand in the place of RNA primer and joins. Then later on, DNA ligase completely seal.
Dear students, I hope you could understand what is DNA replication and how it takes place in a simple manner. Thank you for watching. See you in another class with another topic.